What does a rogue elephant have to do with herbal healthcare? The answer lies in the inspired vision of one man, Mr. M. Manal, founder of the Himalaya Drug Company.
My father had just one concept in his mind, and that was how could he help mankind.
Mr. Manal started by going into the forest on a bicycle to pick roots and herbs by hand. On a visit to Burma in the early 30s, he noticed restless elephants being fed a root to calm them down. He brought that root, Rolfia serpentina, back to India and researched its properties. The end result of that analysis was the launch of Serpina, the world's first antihypertensive drug.
If you put yourself into 1930, you will realize how significant it was that this gentleman thought that, you know, one day, instead of selling roots and plants from the forest, if I could convert this into a tablet and then go and present it to the doctors of modern medicine, maybe they will start believing in this a little bit more than if I was to go and tell them, you take this root.
This scientific approach to Ayurveda was a significant departure. By subjecting Ayurveda, the 5,000-year-old traditional system of medicine, to rigorous research, Himalaya aspired to bring it on par with allopathic medicine.
One of our brands, Live52, is the fourth biggest pharmaceutical brand in the pharmaceutical industry in India. There is no other herbal brand that has this singular distinction. It is the only herbal product registered as a medicine in Switzerland.
Inspired by the philosophy of helping mankind and enriching life, Himalaya aims to be a head-to-toe brand.
One brand, Himalaya, standing for trust for the entire herbal healthcare range for the entire family.
How does this head-to-toe translate in product terms? There are pharmaceutical, consumer, and animal health products. As far as the pharmaceutical range is concerned,
we have this phenomenal range of products which virtually stays with you right from birth through the life cycle itself.
Himalaya's spectrum of pharmaceutical products range from medicines that relieve colic pain in infants to herbal alternatives to hormone replacement therapy for menopause. The pharmaceutical range is complemented by a range of softer consumer products.
The vision has always been that in the personal care area as well, that can we have a range of products which address soft therapeutic needs, which means areas where people are comfortable in self-medicating. We had started off originally with an emphasis towards the healthcare products. Thereafter, hair and skin, where their skin was made a more complete range.
The product range is constantly evolving and expanding. The best way for consumers to experience the head-to-toe concept and become aware of the entire range was to set up exclusive showrooms. Today, consumers can access Himalaya products in leading departmental stores, chemists, and exclusive Himalaya outlets around the world. Behind every Himalaya product, there is a history of inspired research and rigorous testing. Himalaya does not support borrowed science or the practice of using published literature to substantiate efficacy claims. Each Himalaya product undergoes rigorous primary research and clinical trials before it reaches the market.
There are several steps to be involved before a product is launched in the market. That is why we take about 7, 8, 10 years to launch a product.
Just by virtue of a product being herbal in nature does not necessarily make it safe and efficacious. There may be herbal products that have high amount of contaminants, like heavy metals, for instance. The product may have a high bacterial content, which may not be allowed, or a high fungal content that may not be allowed, or may have pesticides, insecticides, aflatoxins, which are again not allowed. Further, the herbs may be picked and processed at a period where the right amount of the active principles are not present. And finally, the processing itself may not be very accurate, because of which the herbal product would not produce the desired results and may have a load of side effects. So the doctors are looking for a product that, although herbal in nature, conforms to manufacturing practices existing for pharmaceutical products. Our products fit the wish list that doctors have for a herbal product.
The fact is, pharmacologically, does this plant do this or it doesn't do it? And modern medicine is all about either it does or it doesn't. There is nothing in between. There is no gray area.
In the manufacturing process, Himalaya can serve as an inspiration for any healthcare company.
Basically, we are supposed to meet the requirements of Schedule T as per the drug authority's guidelines. We are looking at something better than that. There is what is called Schedule M in the allopathic drug control guidelines for good manufacturing practices, which is very elaborate. All these things are done to see that there is consistency in quality of products what we manufacture. And we are incorporating all those norms into our daily activity of manufacturing.
The end result is a range of herbal products that meet global pharmaceutical standards. For a company that was founded on inspiration, it is no wonder that inspired thinking permeates the entire organization.
We bought a software from Mumbai, which after we installed it, realized how inadequate it was. And 3 years down the line, we designed our own software in-house and put it into place. We are able to cope and handle all the incremental businesses of the organization, the increased level of operations, without any changes and without any additions to the staff, because the basic tool which is was designed by us accountants with all the domain experience can cater to any size of the organization in any economy and in any currency.
This inspired thinking is also evident in employee recruitment and welfare.
Mr. Manal asked me, he said, you know, Ravi, I just finished reading a book. And in the book I read that if you see a man who you think or a woman who you think can fit into your organization, and even if you don't have a job for him, take him on or take the person on. So what would you like to do with us? Now that to me was very, very refreshing, because I mean, which company thinks like that? Which chairman thinks like this?
There are very few companies today who still stick to certain basic ethics, morals, and give the people the freedom to do what they want. This truly is one such company. So when people come here, they really don't want to leave this company.
Basically, it is inherited in the policy of the company. We take care of people whenever he or she is in difficulty, whether it's a health problem or any problem to that effect, maybe a financial problem. Company go beyond its capacity and, you know, take care of their problem. That's where I think, you know, we are going to win their loyalty. I think that's something, you know, company has done tremendously well, and people are loyal to the company.
With its strengths of primary research and technology development, Himalaya exports technology to the world.
What we do today is we are exporting technology. We have 3 units today running in different parts of the world where the technology to run that unit is ours.
Throughout history, what has started as one man's flash of inspiration has gone on to touch the lives of millions. What started with one product, inspired by restless elephants, has grown to become a phenomenon that enriches life around the world.
Every quarter of a second, a Himalaya branded product is sold, bought by somebody somewhere in the world. I don't think the man on the bicycle ever dreamt that, but I'm sure he would love it.